So today I'm going to teach you guys how to put a shot put. This is obviously not a shot put, but close to magnifying to size, so there you go. So first things first, when you're holding the shot put, you want to make sure your fingers are separated. That way you got good balance for your thumb. And then you want to put it towards your neck under your jaw. Make sure you're like clavicle, your thumb is pointing towards your clavicle. Guys, that's right here. And don't squeeze it towards your back because it's just uncomfortable. Just make sure it's in a relaxing spot. And then to get yourself balanced, you want to just put it up over your neck. Just put it down. And then, I'll just show you guys how to do it. So when you're throwing it, you want to make sure your eyes are looking up. Because if you throw it and your eyes are like anywhere down, you might end up throwing it like a baseball, and that could really be bad for the rotator's cuff. So just make sure you're looking up, and you want to get a good posture going down, because it's mostly a leg thing. It's not really in your arms. It's just all power in your legs. So you want to get a good like posture, and then release and flick it with your wrist. The wrist flick really doesn't matter, but it helps you get as far as you go. So that would be important if you throw it like that. And that's just a punch, like when you warm it up and start the shot put. And then you also have the glide. That's what I did in the shot put. Like, I was pretty good at it. So that's like the circle. You also stand in a circle too. So you have to make sure you don't step out of the circle or you will get disqualified. So get a good posture again. And then you should be able to stand on one leg. That's how you know if you're standing good enough. Yeah, you want to stand good in a good posture, and then make sure this opposite leg is in a good area. And you want to kick out, and then pop the hip, flick the wrist, and then that's how you do the glide. We also have a shuffle. That's for the bigger guys who can't really get their footwork together. They just do something simple like this, and then flick the wrist. And we also have the spin, and that's pretty much like you want to get in a good posture, bend down. And get a good spin. This opposite foot actually matters if you're like spinning it. That way you get a good momentum going into the throw. And then flick the wrist again. And that's pretty much